Here I am, boys. There is a sign that if you pay someone peanuts, you'll get monkeys. Once again, we're going through what is shaping up to be a very traumatic enterprise bargaining agreement period. Now, ever since the Liberals started this process, we seem to have to justify our reasonable requests for a pay rise more than any other industry does. When Kennett started the EBA process, it sounded like a pretty fair and reasonable thing to do. A pay rise, based on an increase in productivity. We embraced this philosophy with vigour, and our basic level of ambulance care was quickly raised to advanced life support level, which gives a very good level of care to our community. We practiced this for a number of years without any compensation for the very large increase in skills and responsibility that we were given. This was a very large increase in our productivity and should have been fully justified in a satisfactory EBA result. Eventually we did get a miserly increase of skills allowance, insulting really our mobile intensive care ambulance paramedics, known as MICA paramedics, who have many more skills and responsibilities again, receive an even more embarrassingly and insultingly low increase in allowance by comparison. The Labor Party ousted the Libs by a narrow margin, and largely this was because of the way AMBOs were being treated by the Liberals. Well, our joy was short-lived. The Labor Party screwed us even harder, and our last EBA went to arbitration. Our illustrious executive even went into bat against us, claiming our ALS skills were no big deal and were not considered productive enough. Here we are again, just into the EBA, and it's looking ugly already. The Department of Human Services, or DHS, and the government have legislated against us to prevent free speech. We can't just go out on strike, or even plan anything that resembles industrial action, or we could be fined tens of thousands of dollars individually, or even jailed. So much for our freedom of speech. Our forefathers went to war to protect our right to free speech, and they'd be turning in their graves if they knew what was going on now. Recently, some AMBOs demonstrated in Geelong, and word has it that the AMBOs who were off duty and in uniform are to receive a letter of warning, and if they're on duty and they attended, they are to be cancelled. Oh, bloody hell, come on. The Smokies and cops can demonstrate in uniform, but not the AMBOs. We got rid of John Howard recently because of work choices and the Libs trying to screw us out of all our penalties for working weekends and 14-hour night shifts. And now the State Labor Party are trying to do it as well. If that happens, then we'd be better off working at the local hardware shop on a 9-to-5 basis, because we'd be roughly on the same pay. Surely the politicians can't be that bloody stupid. There'd hardly be an AMBO left. So, ladies and gentlemen, despite many changes to our work practices and introduction of computerised patient care records with bugger all training, we are already being told from somewhere that we're not being productive enough for a reasonable pay rise. And I just heard, by the grapevine, if you'll pardon my pun, that the Western Australian AMBOs have been offered a pretty damn good pay rise, which makes them the best paid AMBOs in Australia, with a good chance that the government will approve it. Seems the Western Australian government placed some value on their AMBOs. Looks like I might have to swing in over there. So in conclusion, take care everyone and stand up for our rights and the things we've worked so bloody hard for. Goodbye.